What's going on, everybody? It's the old soldier coming at you again this morning from Robeson County, North Carolina. Apologize for the darkness inside the truck, but it's kind of cloudy and overcast here right now. Sun ain't quite come up over the horizon. But this weekend, all that changes because we've got the time change coming up. I'm actually gaining an hour back, or so it seems. But anyway, folks, hope everybody's doing all right today. One more day closer to Friday. Friday's another day closer to the weekend. That old Loverboy song, everybody's working for the weekend. Everybody's working for the weekend. I know I can't sing, folks, but hey. Yesterday, I gave what I considered an impassioned video about how the ATF is going rogue. I still firmly believe that. And only time will see how that plays out. But right now, folks, things are topsy-turvy, and that's a polite way of putting it. But the odd thing is what I'm seeing across the whole spectrum of social media sources, and I say social media because none of the news is really putting out anything that's trustworthy. Except maybe, and there might be some of y'all disagree with me on this one, but except maybe Tucker Carlson, which right now I can't watch him. I don't have cable or satellite due to the fire, because we turned it off, and I haven't bothered to call him to see if I can get it put in the camper, but that's all right. I can catch the clips after he has his show. Long story short, you know, he's been pinging the whole Biden scandal. Well, back up a few days ago, a few weeks ago, maybe, when Justice Barrett made the president's shortlist and then nomination to replace Justice Ginsburg's seat. There, and then, so last night I'm just, you know, I'm browsing through other things, and I come across this one where I think the title was, even CNN is starting to go against the Biden campaign. I don't know how true that is, but it was one interview. So it was Jake Tapper and one of the Biden campaign staff people, and they were talking about this nomination process and how that it, you know, the Biden campaign was saying it's unconstitutional, that they need to wait let whoever wins the election on November the 3rd make the nomination. And he just come back at her and said, no, that's an opinion, that's a poll. What they're doing, what the U.S. Senate is doing, there's nothing unconstitutional about it. They're doing what they were elected to do. Mind you, this is coming from a CNN commentator. And the young lady kept arguing that it was unconstitutional, and he kept reminding her that, no, that the Senate was doing what they were elected to do. And I just thought it was a very interesting exchange, considering it was coming from the Communist News Network. And the other one was the interview with kooky Kamala Harris. I like to call her a chameleon because it's kind of really what she is. She blends in with her environment until it's time for her to come out. But when, you know, they pegged her about being rated as the most liberal and most far-left member of the Senate. She's like, well, all that was something that Vice President Pence said at the debate. And the cow shot back, well, Senator, that's also from a poll that's been taken. And it wasn't a conservative poll that stated this, but it was... And just the look on her face, like, really? You know, of course, you can't trust that gal as far as you can throw a beach whale, you know. Because she loves to play the victim card, the race card, and all that horse mess. But yeah, she did kind of have an expression of genuine disbelief. That's how they feel about her. They'd ask me, they'd probably got more than they wanted to hear. But so I don't know, folks. I really don't know. And of course, you got nut job Nancy Pelosi that, you know, would rather see the American people suffer and be in pain because she don't like Donald Trump. Just call it the way it is, folks. So if you're in California watching this video and you live in Nancy Pelosi's district, you know, and if you're one of the millions of Americans that are struggling because of the coronavirus and all the shutdowns and restrictions, you know, I don't know what to tell you other than maybe y'all should do like they did to the mayor of St. Louis and or the mayor of Seattle. I mean, go show up on Nancy Pelosi's doorstep in California. Maybe she'll sit down and listen. Take all the city's homeless from San Francisco with you and let them camp out at her place. She seems to have everything she needs, so, you know, she's always talking about how we need to take care of people. Well, go up there and let her take care of you. Using her own money for a change instead of everybody else's. But I'll digress on that one. Yeah, kooky Nancy Pelosi. It's another one that needs to go. AOC needs to go with her. Bernie Sanders needs to retire this year. And anybody with a socialist agenda needs to go ahead and just pack their bags and all move to France, Greece. Oh, wait a minute, they're not truly socialist either. Or are they? But all these other nut jobs up there that want to abolish our Constitution, suspend our Bill of Rights, we need to pack them up and ship them off and go let them live in China, Cuba, Venezuela. They'll be begging to come back in a month. All these celebs threatening to move if Donald Trump's reelected. Well, now we all know a lot of them are blowing smoke in the air. You know, because this last election, a whole bunch of them were supposed to packed up and left. Yet they're still here. They're still a pain in our you-know-what. And they're still running their traps, talking about a whole bunch of stuff. It's a bunch of lies. And spreading a bunch of lies. All I can tell you, folks, is keep your ear to the ground, your eyes open. Watch out for what's going on, because, again, excuse me, None of the sources I've been looking at are accurate in any shape, form, or fashion. None whatsoever. Honestly, the polls, it's really hard to make heads or tails of those. One poll that did strike me as interesting, and Anthony Brian Logan, I don't know if you haven't checked him out, y'all need to go check him out. He's a conservative commentator on YouTube. He talked about a poll that came out of Rasmussen yesterday, and it was about the African American or black support for President Trump. And as of last Friday, the Rasmussen poll showed 46% of black Americans approve of Donald Trump's, what he's doing. Now, does that equate to, you know, votes at the ballot box? Could be. At that high of a percentage, probably not. But to have that high of approval rating. During the last election, he supposedly took 8% of the black vote. I've heard from several different media sources and commentators, too numerous to mention, but the majority of them all have the same thing in common when it comes to the black vote. The prediction is that Donald Trump is probably going to get at least 25% of the black and brown vote. That's another reason why the left is so anxious to give illegal immigrants some type of status to allow them to vote, because they're starting to see their black voter base slip away. Not that a lot are coming to the Republican or conservative side of things, but they're starting to open their eyes for themselves and think for themselves in order to make an informed decision about which way is the best way to go. And that, you know, I'll support anybody. That falls into that category. That, you know, I've got black friends, and they're going to vote a straight Democrat ticket. And there's no convincing them otherwise. There's no trying to, you know, argue the point that President Trump has done more for the black community than any president in the last 40 years. Probably 50. And the fact that the left refuses, won't, you know, on top of the lie about it, but they absolutely refuse to acknowledge it. Restored funding for historically black colleges and universities. Prison reform, first, you know, I can't remember, I think of the First Defender, First Something Act, you know, where 3,000 prisoners were released. The number of, you know, blacks or African Americans that he has given not pardons, but commuted their sentences. Some he's given an outright full blown pardon. And that kind of brings me to the celebrities. You know, of course, you got that one dipstick, 50 Cent, you know, first, yeah, I'm voting Trump because of New York taxes. And then he lets his ex-girlfriend, has been used up, never has been a good comedian, Chelsea Handler, basically shame him into retracting his support for Donald Trump. Now, whether he was sincere about the first one or the other way around, I don't know. Celebrities never know one way or the other what their true intentions are. But Mr. Curtis Jackson is his real name. If he is swayed by an ex-girlfriend to change his vote, probably ought not to be voting to begin with. That's just me. You know, because if she's your ex-girlfriend, what does it matter what she thinks of how you vote, Mr. Jackson? Riddle me that. So I found that, like I said, I found that rather interesting. Anywho, anyhow, anyway, folks. It's definitely going to be an interesting crazy time, if you will, what's going on in this nation. Because I got to thinking about old Roy Boy Pooper Scooper. That's the worthless, craptastic governor we have here in North Carolina. And I got to thinking about some of the stuff he's issued, and then it dawned on me. For all my friends out there in California, come Thanksgiving, I feel for you. I do. But the comparisons of these Democratic governors and their illegal mandates on so-called COVID restrictions. And of course, Roy Boy, issued his executive order mandating everybody wear masks. And we had these phased things about COVID restrictions, and it just went on and on. But yet, he could run around in a crowd of protesters with no mask on. But yet, turn around, come back, and say that public schools and churches could not gather. And he still says he's done nothing wrong there. Okay. Oh, and then also let the state liquor store stay open. If you don't live in North... If you don't live in North Carolina, North Carolina, all the liquor stores are owned by the state. ABC stores, they call them. There's no private ownership of liquor stores in the state of North Carolina. It's a state-run business. Has been since I was a kid. And why? Because for so many years, North Carolina was a blue state. I'm hoping the legislature one day will come to the sense and abolish it. Because the way they can, you know, the way the ABCs are, it's kind of weird how they do it, but the people that kind of oversee the districts are appointed, it's a long, drawn-out mess that needs to be abolished and done away with. But yet, here in North Carolina, those were allowed to stay open. But you can't go to church on Sunday. I think you can now, but initially it was like, nope. So, that was, you know, the other thing I got to looking into last night when I saw a post about it was California's governor's issue about Thanksgiving gatherings. The number of people that could be in attendance at a house for it. The fact that, you know, everybody needed to be outside when eating their meals and bathrooms have to be sanitized. Every so often, I got to think to myself, now California, I don't know how many millions of people reside in California. I honestly don't. But one, I'd really like to see the governor abide by his own instructions. I just got a funny feeling he's a hypocrite and it's going to be one of those orders that do as I say and I'll do as I please kind of deal. And but yet, the other part is, who's going to enforce it? So that tells me right there, it's really a, how do we say, a worthless order? Not worthless. Political. Better term for it, because he's making a boisterous noise, but he's really not doing anything else. Because again, who is going to go into all the neighborhoods to enforce these Thanksgiving gatherings? Because you're also living in a state where they want to abolish the police, so it was a stunt, is really what it is. Because we care about your health. Well, you know. All the time I got for now, folks. God bless, take care, and until tomorrow, soldier out.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life. And I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. Today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land.